while the discussions are going on, I see the consistency of the participants. The consistency is about 250. It's a wonderful audience. Everybody is showing very much interest in learning. I'm even answering some of the questions that they had posted day before yesterday. They're a wonderful audience. They are strictly. So integrating mobile access to teaching and learning. So you had designed certain components. Apart from the self-instructional material, you had designed whatever the pattern, the black and white colored squared pattern, that thing needs to be generated. And then once you generate that QR code pattern, the app, there are several apps, even you can find out on your mobile itself, along with the camera, there will be an app by default, that is the QR code reader app. So this particular QR code reader app by default works with the camera. For the desktops, for the laptops and other kind of devices. And there are certain generators where in which those are meant for mobile based. There are several generators meant for web based, and there are several generators meant for mobile based also. So you can find out these particular things once you go to Google website, web-based QR code generators. You'll get a lot of web-based QR code generators. And when you click QR code generators, comma mobile, then you'll get Android-based, iOS-based, and Windows-based. So these are the three popular mobile operating systems that you have. So all the three mobile operating systems, they have their own mobile-based QR code generators. And then the next thing is the QR code readers. As you have the QR code generators for mobile web-based desktop, as well you have the QR code readers for the web-based and the desktop. Likewise, we have mobile-based QR code readers also. So when you go to your system on the top, you will be finding the several kinds of options like the mobile data. Then you have the speaker, mobile data, location, flight mode, portrait. Some phones nowadays carry the QR code reader also. You can find it on your mobiles. Just see the QR code reader is available. Suppose if the QR code reader is not visible on your device, right? App, I will prescribe one simple app. You can download that app and you can further proceed on the viewing of the QR codes. The next is our digital repository. IGNO has one digital repository which has its own SLMs, self-learning material, YouTube videos. Nowadays, they are placing the FB Live videos also on this egancoach.ac.in. So I had done a simple experiment with my courses, that is C programming course, operating system course, DBMS course, communication skills course. So all these courses contains the equivalent patterns those are meant to access this course material and other things. So what I had done is from the eGANCoach repository, so I had collected all the handles. So there are course material available. So I had gone to that particular course material. On the top, you can see this is the URL. You can say website address. Simply you can say website address. That needs to be copied. So the thing you have to do is that needs to be copied. So that is the only thing. And for that particular URL, you have to generate equivalent pattern. That is the only thing you have to do. And that pattern can be viewed through the QR code reader. So let us see. So I had gone to this particular level of accessing the course material. Then there is one app. You can also know the QR code generator.com. QR code generator.com. www.theqrcodegenerator.com. This is a simple app. Even after Googling, you can get the app. www.theqrcodegenerator.com. This you please make a note. This particular app consists of several options. One thing is e-text. You can see here e-text. The second thing is URL, contact. Likewise, there are altogether 5 to 6 options available on the QR code generator. this particular website is meant for converting the URL, that is the website address, or else any link, even the link is with your Google Drive, that also you can copy, or else the short URL you can copy. You can place it on this text box. This is a text box you can see over here. This is a text box wherein which upon clicking the e-text can be entered, or else upon clicking the URL can be entered, or else contact for contact, in order to convert the whole contact address into the QR code pattern, that also can be done. So what you have to do is like copy the URL, whatever that is visible to you, whatever that you want to share, first of all, then copy that URL, place it in the text box. Here you can place it. Earlier, there will be a static QR code by default existing on the web page. Once you place the URL over here in the text box, then obviously the pattern on the right side here, it will change. That it means that you had automatically generated the QR code for the text that you had placed in the text box. So that thing you have to remember. Once again, I'll repeat, go to the website, that is the generator website. There are several generators. You pick one generator, because I am very much habited with this website. So I am using this website. Otherwise, there are several websites. Just you place QR code generator, comma, desktop version, it will display all kinds of generators, but you just note down this particular URL, which is very much easy for you also. So place the code like www.the-qrcode-generator.com. Then you will have a blank text box here with several options, e-text, URL, contact, likewise. So click on the URL, place the whatever the website address that you had copied, or else whatever the Google Drive site, Google Drive address, the address of the document, whatever you want to share, that address you please copy, paste it here, paste it to the blank space. Automatically, it generates the equivalent static QR code. So this particular QR code is nothing but it is in the image form. Please make a note, it will be in the image form. So what you have to do is place the cursor on the QR code, the image, then right click on it. So it will say copy image as. So copy that particular image. So once you copy that particular image, whenever you want to refer the URL or as the website address that we had pasted over here, just place opposite this particular QR. So how it helps, I will just show you. You can see here, once you click the right click, it will ask for you the size, the pixel size. So better by default, it will show you 200 pixel size. So you better store it in the 200 pixel size, and then you can paste it wherever you want. So how to do it, I'll show you. Then once you generate this particular pattern, wherever you want to paste this particular URL, opposite to that, you can place the pattern also. How it works, let us see. If you have the QR code on your mobile, just scan this particular pattern so that it will take you exactly to this position directly. You have to have the mobile data connection. If you scan this particular QR code pattern using the QR code reader, directly it will lead you to the website address that you have placed. Here, I had placed a simple QR code, again, like simple this one, URL. So you can, and generated this QR code pattern. So obviously it is leading me to some OER, or else open educational material, or else any link, whatever, wherever that it leads to. So then let us see. So this is how you had written your course material. So this is how you have written your self-learning material. So I am just showing you how to place the QR codes. So placing the QR codes is very easy. So we have generated the QR code, and on our self-learning material, normally we leave blank on the left side, like left side page, we leave blank space on the left side, and on the right side page, we leave blank space on the right side, as I have shown, as I'm showing over here. This is the pattern that we follow in Indira Gandhi National Open University whenever we write the, whenever we format the self-learning material. So you have ample space over here. So along with the context, suppose if you have the OER, then if you have the, if you have generated the equivalent QR code, so the thing that you have to do is that you save it as an image, and that particular image, you have to place it context-wise. You can see here in the next slide, this is how I had changed the normal SLM to a multimedia SLM. Multimedia in the sense that this particular, in this particular SLM, wherever I want to refer certain reference material or else open education resource or else a small video which I had developed during this COVID time or else an audio context, a very old audio or else a podcast that I want to share it with my students along with his or her reading. That is important. His or her reading, as per the context, I am placing here the equivalent QR codes. Here you can see that the PPT is shared over here. Whenever I am talking about the history of C, I have one PPT presentation in order to express the whole history of C programming. So how it has been developed from 1970s to 72, 1968 to 72 or so. So that particular thing, I have a very good PowerPoint presentation. So that particular presentation, I made it available in my Google Drive. So I had shared that particular Google Drive location and I had generated the equivalent pattern using the QR code generator. And then I had placed it on the, I had placed it here along with my course material. Once, while the student is learning this particular paragraph, obviously if he is interested in watching the PPT also, then he will take the mobile and he is carrying one QR code app, QR code reader app. So he will just see the QR code reader app. If I am I'll show you once I close this presentation. So when this particular reader, the learner reads along with this particular QR code, the coder, the pattern, then obviously it will take him to the PowerPoint presentation. So he is obviously reading the course material. He is holding the mobile or tab or anything in his hand. He is scanning the code. And obviously that particular link or else the pattern is leading him to the actual PPT presentation. There he can watch the PPT presentation and come back, then go through the other contents over here. Here you can see along with this particular thing, I had placed a video also. So there I had already shot certain videos, 20, 24 videos for the C programming. And logically, context-wise, I am placing the links over here. I am not directly giving the website link for students who need additional support in reading and writing. So using mobile devices, students can quickly gain access to the information by just scanning the QR code and without typing the huge URL, or else without remembering the huge string of URL, he can directly scan and he can go visit the website. And this particular application is not only useful for our open distance learning teachers. However, this application is helpful for best to best the conventional mode teachers also. Suppose I'll show you one thing. So these things, I'll share it with you. So I'll stop the presentation. I'll show you the demo. So here you can see another thing. This is the raw format I am showing you. So as you can watch here, NPTEL, the MHRD, they were having one very good initiative in engineering. So that initiative is NPTEL video course. So NPTEL has given us the complete set of courses. So you can find them on www.nptel.ac.in. So what I had done is, so I had curated all the, course initial locators. Those are the first address of the course. Suppose if you click on this particular address, it will contain at least 40 video programs, 40 serial. This is a series of videos on C programming. But the initial initial page that is provided is the this particular URL. So what I can do is I can paste this part. I can copy this particular URL. Okay, this particular URL, and then copy it, and then I can generate. I can generate the equivalent pattern using the QR code generator. So obviously you will get a QR code pattern in black and white in the form of a simple image. That particular image you can copy and paste it wherever you want, whether in order to share it with your student. The other example I can show it also. So for each and every video that I had, for each and every course that I'm placing over here, another column can be inserted over here on the right, and you can place the QR codes. That particular thing also I wish to share with you. So you can see here, so this is a simple 8-page or 9-page document that I had generated for my student. So this particular document I am sharing with my student by placing it on the Google Drive, or else I can directly send it to the email address of the students, or else I can place the link on my FB page, Facebook page, or else I can send the link of this particular 9-page document on the Twitter also. So this particular 9-page document consists of everything, right from, you can see over here, one course. This 9-page document is enough in order to go through the whole course on C programming. You can see this is the MCA program guide. This is actually the link that we have, and I had generated the equivalent QR code pattern, and I had pasted in the last column. So student can go either by this particular link, that is the website link, or else if he has the printout of these 9 pages, directly he can move, the mobility allows him that he can carry these particular 9 pages wherever he is, if at all he has the mobile data or else the internet facility on his mobile or tab. Directly he can open this 9-page, scan this particular image, and go through the material. So this is MCA program guide, and here lies the actual course material. For each and every block, I had generated the equivalent pattern. Exactly the handle is this one, the URL is this one, and the equivalent code I had generated is this one. So once I scan this particular image, it consists of 4 units links, directly the whole block. Each block is of 4 units. So all the 4 units I can access through my mobile or tab. You can see here block 1, block 2, block 3. So all course material is in his hand. And then he has the lab manual also, along with the course material, the complete lab manual of 60 pages, it is along with him. And for each and every like important component, I had produced the videos also. You can see here, all these videos are available. I had uploaded on the YouTube, and then I had given those particular links over here, and I had generated equivalent pattern and placed it over here. Directly, the student can scan this particular pattern, and then he or she can directly go and watch the video. So all the videos also I had placed along with this course material. the PowerPoint presentations, you can see all the PowerPoint presentations that I had used during my videos, I had pasted over here. These PowerPoint presentations I haven't placed on my Google Drive. However, there is another good website that is slideshare.net. You can see over here. The only requirement is you need to have one Gmail account. So I have a Gmail account. So on that particular Gmail account, I had uploaded all my PowerPoint slides because I want space. So I have to place them on some sort of server. So they are providing the option of placing all my PowerPoint presentations, which I can share it with my student. So these are the corresponding links. And then these are the corresponding QR codes. So likewise, there is a lab facility. And this particular virtual lab facility is being provided by, once again, MHRD Government of India under the initiative of vlab.ac.in. You can also go through vlab.ac.in. But exactly, this is the URL where in which the C programming lab is mentioned. So this particular URL I had copied, and directly when the student scans this code, obviously he will be led to the virtual lab C programming. So directly he can program there, then and there itself with his editor or as the keyboard, then he can execute the program and test the result also without having the compilers and other particular requirements. He can go through the virtual lab, he can execute the program, and he can watch the desired outputs. So likewise, the old code, you can see here the old question papers link. So corresponding to one course, I had placed the complete course material, the complete PPTs, the videos, the virtual lab, the old question papers, the program guide, the reference ebooks. So everything is being compiled under 9 pages, only 9 pages, and I can distribute these particular 9 pages, or else I can upload these particular 9 pages onto the website so that the student can download and he can go through by sitting at his desktop and using his mobile or tab, or else directly he can take 9-page printout, he can carry along with these 9 pages, and whenever, wherever he is, he can open those 9 pages, scan the things, and he can study using his mobile phone. So then, so there are certain, this one also you can see, I'm sharing here. Once you place the QR code generator, obviously it has given me number of QR code generators. The first one you can see here, the QR code generator. Suppose if I click over here, just see the demo. This is free text, URL, contact, phone, and SMS. So what I have to do, I have to take one particular URL. Like suppose if this is the URL, I copy. Or else just see, I'm clicking on URL, www.ignou.ac.in. So you can see here, whenever I am typing, just observe, earlier the message, the static QR code is in this particular pattern. Whenever I am placing one each character, it is giving me a different kind of pattern. So what I have to do is, so this is the equivalent pattern. So once I just, instead of saving, just I'm showing you using my mobile also. So in my mobile, I have one particular application, the QR code. You can see here, the QR code scanner application. So this is the QR code I'm placing on the figure. So directly you can see here, it captured the QR code. And after pressing this particular link, it obviously is leading directly to the website. and programming. You can see here, it consists of four page, and you can see here, there is a, so there are several QR code readers. So you can go through. Otherwise, if you want to have it, if you want to have it on your mobile, if you want to download it in the form of a mobile app, so there are available, there are several available. You can see here, there is a simple app in the Google Store, QR code reader app. So you install this particular app onto your mobile, and obviously it will, like once you scan this QR code patterns, it will help you in reading the material associated with this particular pattern. So this particular application is called as a augmented reality application. So in this particular session, what you had done is, you had converted your normal thing, all the components, the audio component, the video component, the assessment component, everything. So the kind of opportunity to prospects. Learn beautiful things, and they should continue.
Once they start
continuing, they can provide wonderful support through online to each and every conventional as well as open and distance learning student. Thanks a lot. Thanks to all the organizers for inviting